The uneven rounded rectangle in SwiftUI is amazing because it provides unparalleled flexibility in design, unique and dynamic user interfaces. Unlike the standard rounded rectangle, this shape allows developers to customize the corner radii independently, giving each corner a distinct curvature. This feature enables creative and visually appealing designs, making UI elements stand out with a custom touch. Whether you're designing cards, buttons, or custom views, uneven rounded rectangle makes it easy to achieve a polished, modern look while maintaining simplicity in SwiftUI's declarative syntax. Corner radius has been deprecated. It's still around, of course, you may use it. Let me just show you what I mean. So if I type corner radius, as you can see, corner radius will be deprecated in a future version of iOS. Use clip shape or fill instead. So that's fine. So let's just use clip shape instead. So I'm going to comment this out. And you can see, just, removing the corner radius. So we can use a clip shape. And you can use a shape right over here. Currently it's circle. We can use also a rounded rectangle with a corner radius of maybe 15. That's also fine. But what if I want to have different corner radiuses for different corners? Now, that is where the uneven rounded rectangle comes into play. So uneven rounded rectangle. And we are going to use this initializer. So the top leading, let's just use this to 0. That's fine. Bottom leading, let's use 15. Bottom trailing, let's have 30. And top trailing, let's have maybe 100 so we can see it's really, really light. And the style, continuous is by default, but let's just change it to circular. And now this is what we get. So it's really, really amazing. But this is fine and dandy, but you have to remember that it has to be inside a clip shape and it's uneven rounded rectangle. You have to provide top leading radius. Yeah, it's a little bit of cumbersome. Therefore, I would like to see it like this. Corner radius 25, as usual, or, like this again. This is the one that's going to be deprecated. This is the new one that we are going to build out today. Or like this one. So let's do that. I'm going to do this in the same file, so out of convenience, but feel free to just move it into another file and just use it however you'd like. So first of all, I want to control the radiuses on each and every corner. Therefore, I need to create a struct which holds all of the radiuses for those corners. Learning SwiftUI is an incredible opportunity because it simplifies building stunning, responsive user interfaces across all Atter platforms with minimal code. With SwiftUI's declarative syntax, developers can create complex UIs more efficiently, making app development faster and more enjoyable. And now, you can master SwiftUI in just 4 weeks through SwiftUI Camp, an intensive hands-on program designed to get you building real-world projects quickly. Plus, with a 50% discount available through the link in the video description, is the perfect time to invest in your skills and take your app development to the next level. And that struct should be named, and it has the top leading. Go CG float, and then let's duplicate this. We are going to have a bottom leading and then top trailing, and then let me duplicate this so we have not trailing but trailing. There we go, trailing, and then bottom trailing. So we are going to use this in just a second. Now, what I want to do is some sort of create a view modifier. And actually an extension on the view, but it's going to use a view modifier. So let's use Xcode built-in view modifier creation right over there. I don't care about the preview. We are going to name this uneven rounded rectangle modifier. So let me just copy this out so we save some time. So uneven with a capital U, uneven rounded rectangle modifier. That's great. So let me just remove all of the extra stuff that has been added that we are not going to need. And we are going to provide it two things. corners and style. Remember, we had that in the example with the clipping right over here with the clip shade. We had some corners and then the style right over here. So let's just have the corners. So corners, and that will be an uneven rounded rectangle corners that we have just created. And then we have a style. So style, and that will be a rounded corner style, just like that. We don't need to create that, that's already available. Okay, so now let's add that clip shape. So dot clip shape, we are going to use a shape. Let me just add this into a new line so it's better readable. We are going to have an uneven rounded rectangle with all of those. So we are going to grab the corners dot top leading, and I added bottom instead of bottom, there we go. Then corners dot bottom leading, and then corners dot bottom trailing. Make sure that it's okay, everything is in its place, and then top trailing. Okay, and then style from our style, there we go, style. And that's it. Now comes the fun part. We are going to create an extension on the view to accommodate this view modifier. So let's have the extension on the view. And let's start off with the simplest one. So we are going to have the corner radiuses. So func cg float. And we're also going to provide the style. It will be a rounded corner style. Let's give it the default value of continuous. Yeah, you know, that's the default one. We might not want to provide it if, you know, if we are pleased with the default one. So it will return some view, and we just say self.modifier. And we're going to add in the uneven rounded rectangle modifier is this one with the corners. We are going to have the corners created, and let's just have dot init, and then on the top leading we are going to have the radius, bottom leading radius. We are just going to add all of that onto all four of them, and the style we're just going to pass along the style. Now this will just do just a simple corner radius like we have it right over here. Let me just remove the clip shape for now. As you can see, it's corner radius 25. It's not going to be deprecated, it's fine. Oh sorry, it's not this one but this one. Oh, and you can see, there we go, 15. I made the same mistake twice, but no worries. This one is going to be deprecated. This one is what we have created. That's why we have the radius inside those parentheses. Okay, but I want to create the, you know, the clip shape, what we have created right over here. Therefore, I'm going to create another extension on the view. And here we are going to provide uneven rounded rectangle corners. And of course, the style is the rounded corner style, and by default we are going to set it to continuous. It's going to return some view, of course, some view. And now we are also going to use the modifier, and then uneven rounded rectangle modifier. We are going to need some corners, and now we are actually going to provide corner radius. Yeah, we're just going to move the radius inside right over there, and then the style over there. So now we can just uncomment this one, and we have corner radius, and we are going to provide let me just see what's going on. Bottom trailing, top trailing, bottom trailing. I guess I just need to fix this. Just checking. There we go. And yeah, here it is. Top leading 25, bottom leading infinity, and top trailing 15. And we have on the bottom trailing 0, just like that. So we have this uneven rounded rectangle set as a clip shape on whatever view we want it to. And that's it for this video. If you like this teaching style, go ahead and check out SwiftUI Camp. The link is down in the description.